Hello YouTube. This is a video that I made about removing the front wheel and the front forks from the Honda CBX550F. Now this thing has a weird, unique front wheel. It says in the mechanics handbook thing that it takes an hour and a half. It took me more like 20 minutes to get the front off. The front wheel, that is, not the forks. That took forever. The reason I did this was so that I could fix the front, the fork seals and the forks. I did not show putting it back together, so if you're looking for a putting it back together video, you have to look elsewhere. Unfortunately, the reason I made this video is that there are no other videos of doing this on YouTube anywhere. This being a sort of a weird bike. Some little important tips is to use one of these 1.5 inch ABS plumbing pipes to put the new fork seals in to drive them home. That works really well. I highly recommend that. Go to Home Depot, they're like $5. Another thing is the oil inside of the forks, the really thin oil it's called, it's really nasty to get on, gets everywhere. I would highly recommend after you get the oil out, drain them, tip them over. You want to fill them up with gasoline or something, to some solvent to like completely drain them before you start working on them, because it's just a freaking nightmare. Anyways, beyond that, I'm gonna go and show you all the gory details of this and these horrible things as well. Good luck. First step is to put down the center stand and put a piece of 2x4 under there. I tried using these metal things, but they were unstable. Then I put some big heavy stuff on the back of it to put the back wheel down, and I put this jack under it too with just a little tiny bit of pressure to hold the wheel up. Next. After that would be the removal of the anti-dive system. When doing that, there are four of these 5-6 millimeter hex nuts. They have little plastic caps on them. The one weird thing I noticed was this part that goes in here. It looks like you could swap it either way. I think it's the same, but I really don't know that it is. The only difference I could really find with it was how the castings looked. On mine, the side that was out like this was a side that looked like this. If you look at this line here, you'll see it's just a little bit to that edge. And if you flipped it around the other way, you can see it's a little bit to that side, the casting line. I have no idea if there's like different angles or not in it. I really don't know if it matters or not. So after this, also to mention, there's a little gasket in here that is kind of messed up. It came apart of mine a bit. I'm not sure what to do about that yet, but we'll figure out. Next is to take these three off on each side. Okay, I forgot to mention, you also need to get the speedometer cable out. It's just what seems like a simple one little bolt thing there, but if you're taking these off, this is endemic with Honda. It's just a crappy Phillips head in there. You put it in a little bit loose, it vibrates right out and falls off on you. And then, you know, this could come out and get tangled in your wheel while you're driving. You put it in too tight, and because it's a Phillips head, it just gets stuck in there, and you end up mangling the head to try and get it out. Don't know why the hell Honda did that, and they did it in a whole bunch of bikes. So I would highly recommend to go onto eBay and just buy some stainless steel ones. You want to look for M5 by 0.8 thread pitch. 22 millimeters long with a countersunk head. It's like $8 for 10 stainless steel ones with a hexagonal head, so it'll be easy to get in and out. Now over here, next step is this guy right here. On the left side, the anti-dive system holds the brake onto the forks, but on the right side, this does. It's 17 millimeter. And now, gotta go and take off these. They're 5 millimeter. I don't have caps. I'm not sure if they came with caps or not originally. I think it mentions them in the service manual. Yes, it is. I'm gonna put a mark on it. Yes, to be safe. Okay. Yeah, there's the discs. Since this is my first time doing this, I'm making a video of this, even though it's my first time doing this, because there weren't any other videos on YouTube, so hopefully this helps someone out. Okay, apparently the next step is to loosen these two, then loosen this guy here. These are 14, and this is 17 millimeter. I added some wire, to just right here where they connect, so we can hang them so that the flexible part of the brake line isn't marble. So, don't have to take these all the way out. Let me just loosen them. They have lock washers on there. Supposedly, the caliper, the disc, and this cover all come off in one piece, but apparently it requires a bit of persuasion, so we'll see. Oh, that comes up easily. What the fuck was that? Oh, okay. It's one of the things that goes around these. It's got these little metal spacers, shims on containers. They're cold. Alright. Whole thing comes out. And I'll just find somewhere to tie it onto. And oh shit, actually that looks bad. No. Actually probably bad for the brakes. Not that high, I kinda wanna, I guess, try to minimize the amount or the weirdness of the angle that the brakes, that the brake lines are on, which one. Try and keep them somewhat how they were. Of course, the whole reason I'm doing this, the reason that paper towel's there, is because I got my fork seal started leaking suddenly. I'm pretty sure the reason was that I decided to take the bike out in our really cold Canadian winter day. Okay, I'm gonna do that to the other side now. And I guess it just pulls the rubber up. I just got some cheap ones. Just the regular rubber ones. That's what I got. You can get silicone ones though. Now, a lot of the parts on this bike, especially of course the front end, are impossible to come by, but oil seals are actually really generic. They're used across a million different bikes, and actually they're just a generic industrial component for machinery. So you can get them off of AliExpress or eBay or whatever, just as long as you know the size, which I can maybe measure and add to this video. Yes, sir, let's see. Doing some review of the bike, and the guy said it took like an hour and a half for some experienced mechanic to get this thing off. I did nothing. It was easy. Okay. Well, that will show you how to get the wheel off. Of course, I'm not so interested in that. I need to get the forks off too next. I also noticed the anti-dive system on this thing. No matter what number I put it to, it didn't do anything. So I'm wondering if there's something messed up in there. Maybe that gasket went, and there's a little piston in here that presses, and maybe the valve or whatever it actuates got some dirt in there. Maybe that's why it's not working, or maybe it's just a crappy anti-dive system, I don't know. The better anti-dive systems have a, they go from the brake line, there's right from the brake line, it splits off and goes into the forks. That's a really nice one. I'm sure there's fancier ones, but that's what I know is good. Okay, at this point, I've got the wheel off, so I'm going to start working on taking the shocks out. First thing to do is to drain the air that was in them. Grabbing a bag here so I can keep these parts in one place. So now I have that off. Just whoops. Go and
And hit that. Oop, there's oil coming out of there, a little bit of it. Okay. Good. And so now I'll get this off. It might be advisable if this thing's stuck to use a flare nut wrench instead, but seems it came off pretty easily. That's gonna be a real pain in the ass to get back on from the looks of things. Yeah, how am I supposed to twist this? What the fuck? No, I don't get that. That's just weird. Alright, well, maybe I'll try taking out this side. Does that work? Is that a good idea? No. Are they going the same direction? Oh, wait, that would make it worse or better. Nope, that makes it worse. Okay. Well, fuck, I don't know. All I can think of is to just try and do it. It doesn't look like there's any part here that would turn. So, yeah. I don't fucking know. But, alright, you know what, I'm going to loosen this just to be on the safe side. Maybe, possibly, there is some part in there that can turn. So 14. And so is that. So, let me just loosen these other ones here. Oh, that feels weird. I do not like the feel of that. Okay. I'm gonna see, because there's three of them. There's the one from the hose, then there's one that it goes into through a smaller connection, and then it comes from that one to yet another one that you can't see. It's a little one that I use a 10mm wrench on. So I don't even know if this is OEM or not. Okay. Yes, good. Okay, well, that's one of those things I didn't mention in the manual or the service manual, but I'm really glad I didn't try and twist that out. You're obviously supposed to do it this way. Yeah, it just comes right off. I don't really care that I'm hitting this thing, so I'm replacing this anyway. Replacing all the controls and stuff on this bike. Already have this side here done. For the other one, we have to do a little bit of milling on the part to get it to go. Well, this is really speedy. I'm sure it's exciting to watch. There we go. Okay. I got that one off. Get this one the rest of the way off. Now, taking out that little one that I was talking about before, which I don't think you can see. This is quite awkward to do with a camera in the way. I wonder if maybe I could get a socket. Get it out where it goes. There's the part there. It's a little O-ring on that. On the side that goes into the, I think it's called, what is it called? Like the cap of the shock or something. Okay. And now we'll just pull this around. Yeah. Oop, it's dripping a little bit of oil in there. Just jam this in. I can see some oil in there too. But yeah, this thing rotates nice and freely. Okay. So. What size is that? It's a 12. Yeah. Alright, I already loosened it. I'm gonna put that on the floor for now, but I will, of course, bag that up properly in a minute. Okay, so the next thing to take out is these little rings around here. They call them circlips in the service manual. I guess they are. They don't really look like normal circlips, though. But, you know, I'm gonna try and use some circlip pliers on them.
Yeah, right.
With a shot.
Yeah, that seems to be working.
Okay, well, I just need to find something to jam into there. Use this little screwdriver.
Okay. You little bastard.
Okay, there's one down. Back in the bag. And the other one presently. There's a little bit of dust and stuff around here that I'm kind of kicking up by moving these. So I'm just gonna jam some paper towels into these holes just to keep things out. Although maybe I'll go in there and clean it if it's cleanable easily. But you never know, I might forget, so. It'll say some sorry. I guess it'd be pretty hard to forget the paper towel sticking out of that. That would definitely be something you don't want to leave in there. Fucking hell. Sounds really stuck in there. I mean, come on. Okay. I'll just rotate you a bit. There we go. Okay, you try to get it around this thing, I guess, it put it out of alignment or whatever. There's apparently another pair of these under where the handlebars connect. So, I believe the next order of business is the handlebars themselves. And we've got a 10mm bolt going through with a nut on the other side. And oh wait, no, that's for the shocks. This is that's 12. Yeah, and it just goes into the casing there. It's threaded casing. So go and put the 12 onto it. Yeah. comes right off. Oh, I thought there was like a... What the fuck? I thought when I read the service manual that it said there was a thing that like kept this in alignment. Obviously there isn't. How the fuck am I supposed to know where to put it? Maybe there's like a witness mark on it or something? Fuck.
How the shit am I supposed to deal with that?
No. I mean, like, how do you, like, align one to the other? Those seem to be a big pain in the butt. Although I did kind of want to change the angle on them anyway. So, I guess that's not so bad. But it is a little bit annoying. Might as well get the other side? No. Uh-oh. This, the line from the brake reservoir is right in the fucking way. Like, right in the way. Maybe I could loosen the handle and then tip it up slightly. I don't know if I could tip it up enough, though. Maybe I can... Do I have, like, an angle? Maybe if I, nope. Oh, this is going to be a bit of a pain. Next option would be, I guess a trigger wrench. I don't know. Okay, I chewed up the head a little bit. Thankfully, it's in a really out of the way place. Which is, of course, the same reason why that happened. My only real option is to loosen this guy here a little bit. I don't know what else I could do. So that's 8mm. Place this anyway, as I was previously talking about. Oh shit, no, yeah, okay. So, and, yeah, that comes up, good. All right, I apparently only have a half hour recording time on this camera, so I'm not sure what stuff I lost. Basically I just took the circlips out, shoved some paper towel in there, and I'm really not sure where the video ended because this camera has a really crappy user interface. Anyways, I noticed that I had to get to the bolt that secures this handlebar in place. The brake reservoir, the brake cable was in the way, so I just loosened these two bolts here, and I could move it out of the way. Another discovery was what the fuck? Okay, what's that go to? Oh, okay, that's just a little retainer. Okay. Now, what the fuck am I supposed to tie this to? You know what? I was gonna put it like a K1, but really this... It doesn't weigh much or anything. Like... I don't know if I should even bother putting this wire on. None of this stuff here is gonna get terribly injured unless I really yank it on it, so I'm just gonna leave it. Cable could be an issue. Um,
I'm just trying to create some slack on the... Oh, fuck! Right. The brake cable goes down to a...
Yeah, it splits it up for the two halves of the... Because there's dual front disc brakes.
Yeah, this just makes things more awkward, doesn't it?
No, it's going.
Man, look, I'm really having to, like, twist on this thing. I don't like doing that.
That's just my GPS holder there.
Okay. And we have another little wire retainer in there.
It's connected to the fork clamp. It's held on by the bolt that holds it on, actually, so.
I'm gonna have to disconnect for a minute and just leave it like that. Okay.
So next, what am I taking these guys off? Put a left on there. And a, oh wait, yeah, I would already know from this thing. Fuck it, I'll put an R on it. Yeah, I just grease on it. Whatever. Okay. So, to get these off, apparently they just unscrew. And also another weird thing I noticed was that there is a... The shop manual says there's a... Like a second, one of these little, circlips here. They called it a circlip. It doesn't really look like a normal one, but it does its function anyway. Yeah, there was supposed to be one. I see no sign of a second one under it. And to get these off, I just used some circlip pliers and a screwdriver. Okay, if you're wondering. And they do tend to go flying, so be careful of that. Big smooth jaw wrench, and I'll put just a rag around it just to protect it. Handlebars. That didn't take much at all. Yep, really, just barely on there. Okay. Yeah, I think he's recording in springs or something, actually, so I just wanted to at least loosen them, because once I take the forks off, these clamps won't be holding the forks in place, so it would be a lot harder to, because they'd be moving. So while they're clamped, while the forks are clamped, I might as well try and loosen those. I thought they'd be on there a lot tighter. So, next I've got to... So move the camera a bit. Let me just get off the tripod for a second here. So that's the bolt that holds the fork on up there. Next thing I want to do is remove this guy. And remove the fender. And remove whatever this thing's called. There's some little plastic caps here that just pop off. And got to remove the speedo cable and the brake line from this thing too. So I got focus. I'm doing it manually because all the focus on this camera is pretty shit. Okay, up next are these terrible bastards here. You can't push it out of here with a cable on it, not as far as I can see. I mean, if you succeeded, I think you would maybe damage the cable. This thing that's attached to this metal thing, there's no real good way to like try and prize it back or anything, unless maybe you had like some specialized tool. Back inside here where it connects, it's just welded on, it's not bolted on, so you can't just unbolt it. Basically the solution I came up for it to get it off was to jam this tapered punch in and then just sort of, you know, pull it off. I also, before I did this, I put a ton of silicone, like spray on silicone lubricant on it, just to try and soften up the rubber and make things, you know, a bit more smooth, which I'm continuing to apply. But when I did, you know, pull it out, the problem was that the diameter of this was too big, and I tore the one on the other side. I'm still going to use it because honestly, it's probably fine. I don't even know how necessary this thing is. But for this one, what I found out that works is I just shoved this thing all the way in to sort of expand it, and then I put this smaller straight punch in. So, you know, I'm gonna hopefully be able to get this one out. There we go. Now, I have no clue how I'm gonna get that back in. But I got it out, so that's the important part, right? Okay, so up next, we have, let me just put a tripod up here. I've got to get rid of this fender and related accessories. So, like I said before, there's these four caps which come off with needle nose pliers. I haven't actually tried to get the back ones yet. Ugh. Come on. There we go. And oh god, this is awkward. Yeah. Okay, good. Into the bag with you. Okay. And I got this one in. It is 6mm. Maybe I should do this first. Yeah. Oh fuck, that is in there. Okay, do the easy ones first, right? These ones will no doubt will leave you much more fun. Okay. It's all four loosened. And I guess to take out the rest of the oil, just put this extension on it. And well, that's too much of an extension. Just because the extension has a bit of knurling on it, and then I can just get these up by hand. Well, that's what I'm gonna do. Yeah. nice loose now. I wonder if maybe I can take this thing, what's it called, the Fort Bridge or something like that, and maybe I can polish it up and put some clear coat on it. Yep, looking a bit nicer. That goes for the rest of the aluminum on this thing too. Could really use a brightening up. Look a lot better polished. Or even just brushed. I mean, ugh. Okay. So that's off. Next, I've got to get the fender off. It looks like it's held in by four 10mm ones. So, grab myself this 10 here. And, you know what, there is absolutely nothing exciting about taking this off, so I'm just gonna pause the video here. Alright, next up, I'm gonna finally be able to remove these shocks. There's two sets of clamps on the triple tree. There's these down here, and some up at the top. Take the ones down here. I gotta take this cover off. I only took it off once before, it's like, don't really remember exactly what's behind it and how accessible things are. It's just a Phillips, two Phillips screws here. That seems odd. Maybe there'd be one up top too, though. I think there'd be more than two. Let's see. No, there's just two. Okay. So, yeah, there they are. Those look like 12s to me. There's also all these like weird, I don't know, you can't really see it, but how these signals connect is pretty odd. I bought some new signals for it off eBay. Because these ones are just so fucking ugly and dated looking. I'm not taking the bolts all the way out, of course, we're just loosening it. Okay. So I'm gonna have to make some custom brackets to hold the new ones in, but when I say custom brackets, I mean just, you know, bending a piece of sheet metal and drilling some holes in it. Okay. Now, up here, let's get this camera up to where it should be. You've got these ones. And it's 10mm. And go to the other side. Yes. Okay, nice and loose. Okay, so apparently the forks will just come right out now. Yeah, not so. So I got a non-marring hide hammer here. Hopefully, that's what is the trick. There's a little, I just went past it, but there's a line there. Cause it's like this line here, there's one a little bit below it. And that's the one you line up with. So the top of this bracket or whatever the fuck it's called is lined up with that other line there. I wonder how I'm gonna get this back in. I mean, if I have to hammer it out, and I can't really hammer the bottom of the shock absorbers because, you know, they're shock absorbers. Oh, wait. Oh, no, it's twisted now. Okay. Yeah. Again, there's more faulty information in the service manual that says that there's something that keeps the fork aligned the direction it's in. Obviously, there isn't. There's the fork off. But the forks, they just sort of seem to turn freely. So I'm just gonna put them in and then turn this to about 45 degrees, so, you know, offset to approximately how it was, because it only has to be approximate. So I'll just do it by eye. No big deal. Okay, I'm gonna put this thing down. I don't want it leaking oil anymore. Oh, also, if you have any dirt on, this is a really tight fit, so if you have any dirt or anything, you want to clean them off so that it won't get caught as you're pulling it down. And, you can say, I guess all the other ones going to go. And, I guess next I'll have to actually install the O-rings. Well, not O-rings, oil things, whatever. I'm trying to fix this.